Women's doubles. The mixed doubles is now our focus of attention. Zheng and Huang up against the Indonesian pair, Kusharjanto and Kusumawati. That's our top match. See the Chinese, the only seeds that have made it through to the semis.
This is the YONEX All England Open Badminton Championships 2023. Give it up for the players. First up, the number one seeds from China, Zheng Siwei and Huang Yajiao.
Without question, the pair to beat in this competition. And the next to try and do just that, Kusharjanto Kusumawati of Indonesia, about to be introduced.
And give it up for their opponents from Indonesia. Kusharjanto, Alisa Ayo, Kusumawati.
Excellent crowd inside the Utility Arena here in Birmingham. And it's only going to get bigger as we go through the day. And of course, tomorrow, we'll bring you all five finals live from 10 o'clock local time. The second semi-final session today, by the way, 5 p.m. local time here in the UK. They've won both previous meetings, the last of which in the India Open just earlier this year. Actually won that in 31 minutes. Time world champion in 2018, 2019, and again last year. A pair that have been together for a long time. They won their first title back in 2017, and already this year they've taken down the Super 1000 Malaysia Open. And his partner, Feng Yao Chong, of course, they teamed up for silver at the Olympics in Tokyo. 24 world tour titles, okay, astonishing record, including this championship back in 2019. They got to the final a year earlier. They were extended by Li in the second round, went to three games. Otherwise, it's been pretty much plain sailing yesterday. Just half an hour to take care of Kaneko and Matsumoto. And Kusharjanto, we saw yesterday, if you were watching our coverage, they really were impressive, this pair. Ranked 15 now, they were up at number 12 back in January. Comes from a real badminton background. His dad's Olympic silver medalist in mixed doubles back in Sydney in 2000. Mum's an Asian champion as well in the 90s. And Kusumawati, it was terrific yesterday. Their big breakthrough as a pair, these two, was at the high-low open in Germany last year. That was a Super 300. And this tournament, actually, first time they've got past the fourth round in 2023. There's that great victory they had against Yamashita and Shinoya yesterday. Really hard-fought battle that was. Hour and a quarter in three games. What do you reckon here then, Steen? Can Kusharjanto and Kusumawati find a way to hurt the Chinese top seeds?
No. No, it's going to be difficult. It's going to be difficult. But they're an upcoming pair, and there's no doubt that Rehan Kusharjanto would love to emulate his father's best effort in this tournament, which is a final from 1997. Lost to the then dominant Chinese pair of Liu Yong and Giffey, but their recent head-to-heads suggests that it's going to be very difficult. Always checking the knees of Zheng Siwei, because if he's injury-free, then
ladies
he's very,
and
very
gentlemen,
hard to handle.
On my right, Zheng Siwei and Huang Gaochong, China. And on my left, Rehan Naufal Kusharjanto and Lisa Ayu Kusumawati, Indonesia. Huang Gaochong to serve to Rehan Naufal Kusharjanto. Lavor, play.
Really do relish the fans here in Birmingham the chance to see some of the best Asian players in the world here in Europe. Such an eagerly awaited tournament, this. And all the way back to 1899, the first All England. And in fact, that year, there were no singles, it was just up. Problem for Kusharjanto and Kusumawati is that these two get off to a fast start, the Chinese pair. They're very good front runners. You don't see them for dust. Know the extent of the task. Huge cheer for the Indonesians getting themselves on the board in this opening game. Indonesians in the crowd in full voice already. It's only 10 past 11. So from love four to four all. There's a spirited response.
Yeah, very good start.
can seat 16,000. The utility arena, and we are pretty full, as you can see. Well, it was great defence while it lasted, but the top seeds having to really engage here.
Super fast on his feet, Kusharjanto. There's the Chinese coach, Yang Ming.
Made a couple of errors so far, Huang Lechong. Used to seeing that very often.
No, they were made to go the full distance in the second round against Lee Chun-hei and Ng Siao from Hong Kong. So maybe my prediction, my very quick prediction, which I stand by.
Well, you're not allowed to change it now, so you have to
come
stand
through.
By it.
Yeah. Is that they've been able to sort of get control over some rallies. It'd be very, very hard to get the initiative against Zheng Siwei and that Huang Lechong.
Two Indonesians stranded on one side of the court, and the shuttle went the other with a sumptuous angle created by Huang Lechong. Top seeds in front at the mid-game interval, but far from having it all their own way.
Oh, huh? pasti ada yang nembak ke cewek.
Iya. Jadi tinggal kamu tungguin aja, tapi kalau dia kamu paksa
20 ya. Seconds.
Juga enggak ada masalah.
20 seconds.
Enak ya. Oke ya. Nah, lihat bola lagi ya. Ya. Mulai dari start service terima service. Ayo.
Super important if she can challenge Huang Yachong. Interesting that it was Leonie Meineke, the head of performance in Indonesia, who was coaching the Indonesian mixed doubles, just said goodbye to Nova Vidianto, who was employed by Malaysia. And fantastic rally.
Well, mixed doubles at its very best. And they're definitely worrying the top seed, Tisti. This is enthralling so far.
To lift as flat as they can, the two Indonesians, to not give Zheng away the angle. What an interception by Huang Yachong there.
11.
Absolutely amazing. And also, so Nova Vidianto and also Flandre Lempele, who also worked with the younger mixed doubles players. Both left Indonesia, and the mixed doubles coach, Amon Sunario, is, I don't know if he's here in Birmingham, but he's definitely not coaching this match here. John leaves it and then turns away. Suddenly picked up speed there. Then Kusharjanto. Capitalizing on the unprecise shot from Zheng Ziwei. You're right, Trevor, they're definitely vulnerable. They look vulnerable at the moment. The what number ones. Beautiful flat play.
Gets a thumb up from his partner.
Yeah.
The fact that the Indonesian pair sticking with the Chinese in this tight opening game. That's a good lead by Zheng.
Thank you.
That was right into the hitting zone from Huang. Got exactly what it deserved. He's got that all wrong. It was an absolute gift for Lisa Kusumawati. Blow for blow at the moment. Fantastic point. Unbelievable play from both pairs.
This shows how difficult it can be to beat the Chinese. I think it was excellent flat game, but how on earth did Huang Yachong take that so early?
A little bit of help from the tape, but you make your own luck sometimes.
Wow.
Just the slightest feather over the net. Worth the admission money on its own, that rally. But still, right in the balance this opening game.
And this is one of the situations where the Indonesians have to really be alert, because we'll see an increased focus from the Chinese.
Oh, they're going to challenge that for absolute certain. I saw that wide.
And I'm not totally sure. I think he quite easily could have caught the line, but let's see what the review system has to say.
This is massive. 18-15 or 17-16. Huge decision for Hawkeye. Missed the line.
You're right, Trevor. First 16, game of the match, Kusharjanto and Kusumawati. Really, really strong in the flat game.
Super shot to drag Kusharjanto so wide, he somehow got to it, but the easiest of kills, and it sets up three game points for the top seeds.
20, game point, 70.
But what a fantastic advert for mixed doubles this opening game has been. May yet be more drama in it, because they're not over the line, not quite yet. Well, it wasn't plain sailing, and the scoreline doesn't quite tell the story, but 21-17, the Chinese pair take the opening game in hugely entertaining fashion. Of battle for Kusharjanto. Yeah, that hurts. Ow.
Bruised when the players are diving for
second game
smashes.
What a wonderful way to start from Kusharjanto. Injured hand or not. Standard dropping at all. I think that was called in and it's been challenged by China.
It's a great disguised drop shot from Kusumawati.
Line judge saw it clipping the line. Let's find out what Hawkeye says. Same thing. Well, if they could get off to a fly here, Kusharjanto and Kusumawati, that really would put some pressure on the top seeds.
Good deception by Huang.
So, 1-2.
Look how she controlled it. Yeah. Yang Ming signaling that that's something that they've been discussing, and I could easily see Huang Yachong's role in the flat game be a lot like this, covering the cross. And if it's more slow-paced rallies like this, then it's about being close to the net. Good play. Hilded a little. Leon pushing on to. Oi, what a save.
That is a bonus point for the Indonesians. It really is.
4-1.
Yeah. There's not a lot of those. She misses Huang Yachong.
Well, everything's going for them at the moment. What a start here. Kusharjanto and Kusumawati. Really spirited response to losing the opening game.
I think they've done really, really well here. I'm especially impressed with Lisa Kusumawati. That has been a force on the front court. I knew that I've seen Kusharjanto play at a high level earlier, and Lisa also at a very good level, but this is... This indicates that something extra has been added.
Didn't see this scoreline coming.
No. Took a bold decision I think a year and a half ago with the Indonesians, saying goodbye to their two top mixed doubles, Elvis Faisal and Gloria Vijaya, and Perrin Jordan and Oksanianti no longer in the national team. They thought they were not progressing. Indonesian team management, and started developing the young mixed doubles.
3-7.
The difficulty for Kusharjanto and Kusumawati, that they're playing with the drift, so the lifts are more difficult to be accurate with. If they're on top of the tape, though, they get a little bit extra help in the flat game and the attack.
Well, they were 7-1 down, back within two now. And that's the response of the world number one pair.
5-7. Thank you. On point.
Service. Of course, also the interception on the third shot from Huang Yachong, but it was a service who sent it all up.
Oh! actually.
What a fantastic defense from Huang.
It was very effective.
Crosses the next one. That's unbelievable. And that one as well. Wow.
Even Harry Houdini never escaped like that.
That deserved better, in my opinion. But what a fantastic rally by the four players. I needed slow motion is not enough. I needed slowed down a bit more to be able to follow it. Oi, there's a
and obviously,
traffic jam.
If that goes in, that's it. They weren't getting there.
No, no, they weren't.
It's just absolutely astonishing. Now we're going to get a three-shot rally.
Yeah.
No. There you go.
Two.
Ten.
And
eight.
Nine of the last 10 points for the world number ones.
And the thing is, you know, the crowd, they're here for the first session. Some of them, I guess, might come back as well this evening if they book for both. And they go home and they'll explain to anyone who's there about that rally. They're talking about it for days. It'll be on videos. It'll go viral right around the world at that point. Meanwhile, they're 3 points ahead at the mid-game break, having been 7-1 down. Worth seeing again, worth seeing about 5 or 6 times, but this is just astonishing.
Play.
Back live.
Chen Shui. He would have liked if Huang Chong had left it for him or played it better.
Saliento, and they're back level again. It's topsy-turvy second game. 7-1 down, remember, the Indonesians. Oh, sorry, 7-1 up, I beg your pardon, then 11-8 down. And now in turns again. Top seeds know they are in a battle here.
Chong. Great awareness to take the pace out of the shot. It's not often that it's a good idea for Zheng Siwei and Huang Yachong to reduce the pace in the rallies, but here I actually think it was, because as soon as it's flat game, there's a lot of pressure on the Chinese, and just one good attacking opportunity doesn't seem to be enough oftentimes.
That made it.
This is very, very entertaining. Mixed doubles.
Well, I tell you what, they're just starting to really threaten again. The Chinese pair, who in the first game had some moments of anxiety, have some more right here.
Yeah, and it's like they won't go away, the Indonesians. Doesn't get any angle to work with. There's the chance. Fantastic. Playing well. Strong, strong comeback after losing that amazing rally at, was it 8-all? Losing two quick points afterwards.
They've won 7 of 8 points since the interval.
And then, and rightly so, I mean, they truly deserved it. They are doing better in the flat game. And there's a lot of stress on the world number ones.
And they're making mistakes. 16. And the Indonesians, favourites now, to take this game and level the match. Crowd would be thrilled with that, probably because there are more Indonesian fans in, but also because they just want to see more of it.
Kusumawati, she's taking over control of the net. At the moment, she's beating Huang Yachong there. That's an incredible development. They are shaking the world champions. To come up with something, because they're finishing an eventual third game on this near side of the court as well.
Might be too late, too little too late, we suspect, in this game, unless something quite extraordinary happens here.
Over and over again. They don't know what to do.
7 game points then. For Kusharjanto and Kusumawati to level up here.
She's beating Huang Yanchong.
One game all it is. How many of you saw that coming? We're going to have a decider in this mixed doubles semi. And from what we've seen, it genuinely could go either way. One game all. 2nd game.
Yeah, they lost the second part 13-2. And the Indonesians got their first ever game win. That's a great save.
Feature of this match is a number of points where the Chinese appear to be huge favourites. The Indonesians have been on the defensive and somehow come up with a point.
And again, Lisa Kusumawati defeating Huang Yanchong at the net. And I think a lot of the Chinese game plan is relying on winning the service situation, getting on the attack.
We haven't seen too many of those clean winners, have we, from Zheng Siwei?
No, they haven't been allowed to play from that high above the tape. And the question mark is whether the Indonesians can sort of balance their game, not overdo it, not become a little bit too tentative and have to lift. Zheng Siwei on the last two serve returns, he's been very, very alert. What happens the next time the Indonesians are to serve to him? Wow, lucky for Zheng Siwei and Huang Yachong. She won it again. Lisa, the battle for the initiative.
You can do against that the last couple of points
and Lisa, all that rubbish about apologizing when you hit the top of the tape, that's nothing for her. She just celebrates.
Give it the fist pump.
Yeah. Expresses her true feelings. Back on now. Chip.
Oh, not again. Not again. She better do the lottery later.
Yeah. 6-5.
They're not getting one moment of peace and quiet. Zheng and Huang.
And Zheng and Huang at the moment must feel like they're playing the gods as well as Kusharjanto and Kusumawati.
At the moment it's Huang Yachong who's struggling a bit more than Zheng Siwei, I think. Jumps away. Fantastic play. Huang Yachong. Backhand drives.
6-7.
Finally, some comforting play from Huang Yachong.
Is she aiming for it?
Yeah, I think so.
Literally, blow for blow, point for point at the moment. And who's going to come out on top is still anyone's guess. Lands another one.
9-8.
I couldn't get enough length on it. He's at Kusumawati. That might be a solution for the Chinese to flick her a bit more. He's playing well at the moment, Zheng Siwei.
So 11-8 it is, but then it was 11-8 in favour of the two Chinese at the end of the mid-game break in the second game, and they went on to lose it. Still right up for grabs this semi-final.
Everything seemed to tumble over for Kusumawati and Kusharjanto. He's laughing as well, reeling in line again. Beautiful. What a battle we have here.
Yeah, and we've got power and subtlety in equal measure. This was the purest of touches from JC Wei. Wonderful shot. Still won't lie down.
It's like two cars going directly at each other, and none of them want to divert. Every single rally, we try once more.
It was definitely pulled in, and immediately the Indonesians want Hawkeye to double check.
And it was called out.
Oh, was it called out there?
Yeah, it's the Chinese challenges.
It definitely looked out, didn't it? Yeah.
Just call the line.
The line!
Wow. And James Away celebrating.
Well, how important could that be? Well, it worked, but more by accident than design. Left it to each other, weren't sure what to do, but in the end it dropped beyond the back line, so no harm done from a Chinese point of view.
again. He's stepped up, Jensi Wei. He really has. It's going wide. Ooh, it's a good.
They've suddenly found another gear.
And the moment they're lifting the Indonesians, they're in trouble. I actually think Lisa Kusumawati is staying too much on her feet in her defense. She's much more dangerous when she's sitting down, and even more when she's lying down. We saw that earlier. Missed it. They were playing at the edge of their capability in that second game. The Indonesians were difficult to maintain for an extended amount of time. Not often we see Huang Yacheng being consistently beat at the net. More credit to this lady here. Fantastic defense. Dragon's gone. She's playing singles.
Down and almost out.
There, his racket's gone.
Yeah, you take over.
Well read by Huang Yacheng. It was going to be a drop shot.
Seven match points for Jensi Wei and Huang Yacheng. In a match that has been hugely entertaining. And at one point, the top seeds look to be in trouble. Apparently, they've dug themselves out of it. One more point required. And there it is. Scoreline really doesn't tell the full story. You can tell it's as much relief as celebration from Zheng. If Kusharjanto and Kusumawati can look back on that with genuine pride, it was magnificent to watch. The crowd loved it. It featured one of the greatest rallies you'll ever see. But in the end, it's the world number one pair and top seeds who will be in tomorrow's mixed doubles final.
Absolutely amazing badminton.
It was just a great advert, wasn't it, for mixed doubles?
Yeah.
21-17, 13-21, 21-13.
How good was Zheng Siwei here in that third game? That was amazing.
I think he enjoyed that. But I think the nature of those celebrations is testament to how tough it was at times for the top seeds in that match.
Yeah, they were being tested. We have many good encounters between these two to look forward to.
And played in a terrific spirit as well. And that rally, that astonishing rally, will live long in the memory. So, 21-17, 13-21, 21-13. An hour encore, an hour of magnificent badminton entertainment. Coming next, we're going to switch the attention to singles. The world's number one woman, Akane Yamaguchi, against the Olympic champion Chen Yufei in Unlimited. Welcome back to Birmingham, and how on earth do you follow that phenomenal mixed doubles semi-final? Well, we think we can. We had the top woman in the world, Akane Yamaguchi of Japan, up against the Olympic champion Chen Yufei. Number one seed versus the number four seed. And two extremely popular women. I'm sure they're going to get a huge reception here. That's how the draws panned out. The top four seeds all making it through.